Will Elon Musk help usher in the Antichrist? Elon Musk bought Twitter. And like a stroke of lightning, with 5 Twitter file downloads, he has been knighted as a champion of free speech. And I admit, I have chuckled myself as he is bringing down many of those who have suppressed speech over the past couple years. Many times, it was my speech that was suppressed. But before we begin to think Musk is on the side of good, and that is what the media wants you to think right now, we need to reconsider where his heart is on matters much more important than free speech. And in those areas, I really question if he is not a plant, a spy, someone sent here by the forces of evil to be a prophet, maybe for the Antichrist. Not the Antichrist, not the false prophet, but a Pied Piper of sorts that will lead people to destruction. I say, fear him. And let's see why I feel that way. But first, a shout out to a member of our advisory board, Michael Terran, who helped us research this project. Now back to Musk. First, there's no doubt that Musk is taking shots at people who most deserve the heat, people who have lied to us and suppressed the truth. No doubt about it. Like on Sunday, he quipped, "My pronouns are prosecute Fauci." This endears him to all of us damaged by the pandemic and by those who were responsible for lockdowns and mandates. But think for a moment. Ask yourself, why the same media that suppressed anything outside of their narrative when the pandemic was ongoing are now allowing exactly the opposite on their airways? Attacks on the same people who they defended. Why is that? Doesn't that seem strange to you? It wouldn't be strange if the reason was to make Musk look like a trusted hero, to build him up as someone we could believe in. Right now, Fauci is retiring. They don't need him anymore. He is worthless to them. Easy to sacrifice to the media gods. They only protect those that they'll need in the future. It is an easy way to tell who is still in their game plan. For instance, my guess is that this former president is untouchable because they plan to use him in the future for a future role. That's why we hear nothing about him that's negative in the media. Musk doesn't go after him if you haven't noticed. As I frequently say, the media and politicians lie when their lips are moving. And when what they say agrees with you, you really need to ask yourself, why? Since their agenda is so self-serving. So now we understand why Musk has Twitter and why he isn't being censored. It is to set him up as a hero of sorts so that when he says something that is very dangerous, we will trust him enough to go along with it. Makes sense, right? So enjoy the Twitter wars as they happen, but don't trust him. He is not on your side. He is like Zelensky, a puppet to further the globalist transhumanism agenda. Which brings us to the dark side of Musk. Transhumanism, AI, aliens, China connections, and Satanism. Let's start with Satanism. Here's what Musk dressed as this Halloween. Nice Satan outfit, isn't it? Now, outfits alone don't make anyone a Satanist. He also dated a singer named Grimes who admitted to Wiccan associations and casting spells. That doesn't make someone a Satanist either. Elon's mother has been accused of practicing South African witchcraft and always seems to give the classic one-eye Illuminati magic symbolism in many of her pictures. His sister directed a movie about an elite family of witches. And Jeffrey Epstein, of all people, was a consultant at Tesla. Now, none of these things in and of themselves say Satanist. However, if he isn't, he sure takes the idea of dark forces very, very lightly. Now, Elon Musk's grandfather was a guy named Joshua Halderman. He was the founder of the technocracy movement, controlling and ruling people with technology. Just this month, Musk's SpaceX program rolled out a new breed of surveillance satellites called Starshield. The U.S. Department of Defense are buying some, but so are other nations like China and also private corporations. In fact, Elon was approved to launch 7,500 of these satellites. 7,500. Elon is now in the surveillance business. Doesn't that make you feel spied on? The Antichrist will likely harness a satellite network just like this when he comes to power. Musk will build it and the Antichrist will use it. The same can probably be said for Musk's most famous company, Tesla. By the way, did you know that China is the number two market for Teslas? And that China owns a substantial share of Tesla stock? Maybe that is why the Chinese government prohibits its military personnel from renting any kind of EV while overseas. Maybe because they know electric vehicles spy on their drivers, listening, and even filming their actions. Of course, the future Antichrist will love a network of such cars in the future, if he even permits cars. But the greatest surveillance and control effort of Musk, of course, is Neuralink, which is developing devices that can be implanted into your brain, allowing humans to interface directly with computer software. With this type of technology, on the good side, humans could combat degenerative diseases, stroke, paralysis, as well as Parkinsonism, epilepsy, dementia, Alzheimer's. Wow, it sounds great. They could acquire superhuman intelligence, and of course, if the computer tells the person what to do, as opposed to vice versa, the computer network could control every person attached to it. This is the real threatening and dangerous part of this technology. Naturally, the Antichrist would love to have that ability, and we do believe he will have it. This may actually be the infamous image of the beast found in Revelation 13. Something we have discussed in numerous videos. However, our current thinking is that a genetic upgrade of some sort will lead to this control of thinking, not Neuralink. Using something called quantum entanglement. We discussed this in this previous video, and there is a link down in the description. I suggest you watch it after this one. It is very interesting. This would be a wireless system based on DNA changes alone. Something we really need to watch out for and beware of. So the current Neuralink system in our minds is a preliminary form of brain-to-computer interface. But because of the drawbacks of surgery being required, future infections, a bulky interface link, batteries, etc., humans won't flock to this at all. That's why I expect Neuralink to simply pave the way to brain-to-computer interfaces, to whet people's appetites for this technology, so that when the quantum entangled DNA upgrade comes, people will gladly take it. Who knows? Musk might be the guy to help develop that as well. It is also possible, probably even more likely, that it will be fallen angel technology that leads to the genetic quantum entanglement. As we Christians don't routinely think of Satan and his fallen angels and their being cast to the earth. You know, this takes place when Michael, the archangel, does this at the midpoint of a tribulation. But scripture tells us this is going to happen. Well, what will it look like? How will their interaction with humans be when they're on the earth? Obviously, it's different than it is now. The Bible tells us this is happening, so it is different. When the sons of God came to earth back in the days of Noah, they brought all sorts of primitive technology, things like music, weapons, magic, and evil spiritual spells, things like that. So it is entirely likely that when Satan and his horde of demons are unleashed again, that they will bring technology, which may include wild stuff, like the quantum entangled DNA we've been talking about. Now, what form might these fallen angels take when this happens? It's possible that once they are cast to the earth, they will disguise themselves as aliens. I think that's entirely likely. And guess who has an overwhelming interest in aliens? Elon Musk. The recent G20 meetings of the world leaders, Musk did not attend like Klaus Schwab did, but he did join them by means of a web-based call from the USA, and Musk spoke of aliens. Part of Musk's interest stems from his SpaceX venture, of course. In addition to mentioning them at the G20, his first meeting with his new Twitter employees had alien discussions in it. Isn't that bizarre? He spoke of them to Ghislaine Maxwell also, all the way back in 2014. And he's just obsessed with aliens. He mentions them all the time. So when Satan and his horde are cast to the earth, who might be the first to be in contact with them? We don't know. We're only surmising, but it could be Musk and his SpaceX group. I could imagine Musk being overwhelmingly receptive to those he calls aliens and very eager to accept their technology. Musk may be the one welcoming Satan to this earth in bodily form. Think about it. What about AI? Musk is generally fearful of AI. He's tweeted and written articles about this lately, saying that we as humans should be fearful because AI could destroy us as a human race. This may have the same effect as Musk being a warrior for free speech. If Musk changes his mind and says, oh, this form of AI is completely safe, this is what we need to trust, because he's been opposed to it in the past, and people would see him changing his mind and going along with a new form of AI, perhaps that will be a step that causes many people to trust it as well. We need to be careful about anything that Musk says. Great question at this point. Is Musk saved? Some probably say he is. Well, in a recent serious, not comical, Babylon Bee interview, the interviewer said to Musk, slightly tongue-in-cheek, quote, Babylon Bee is a Christian organization and we're a ministry. To make this church, we're wondering if you could do us a quick solid and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior right now, personal Lord and Savior. It's a quick prayer. They actually asked Musk to get saved. Musk sat stunned. He then replied, quote, I agree with the principles that Jesus advocated. There is some great wisdom in the teachings of Jesus, and I agree with those teachings. But hey, if Jesus is saving people, I won't stand in his way. Sure, I'll be saved. Why not? End of quote. But he didn't pray the prayer. Nor is simply reciting a prayer what salvation is truly about. So no, he isn't saved, which isn't surprising. But all these things Musk is involved in aren't the greatest risk to Christians over the next 5 years. Click right here to keep watching and discover what is the greatest risk to believers. Till then, this is Nelson, and I'll see you there.